Today we want to cover failure modes and risk analysis. So you may get asked a question simply, what is failure modes and risk analysis? How would you create this program and who should be involved? So as usual, if you know a task group or a reference for whatever you are being asked, always mention it first. So in this case, TG100 is our best friend. Reference that immediately. And if there's anything you're unsure of, or even as you answer each one of your questions, say, oh, and I would reference TG100 or follow TG100 protocols, things of that nature. So FMEA here, failure modes and risk analysis. This is a prospective risk analysis. So essentially, we are going to take each step in the radiotherapy process and we're going to assign it a risk. And that risk is given by a RPN number. RPN stands for risk probability number, and that is equal to O times S times D. Now, O stands for occurrence. So that's how often it may occur. S is severity. So if this thing were to happen, how severe would that be for the patient? And then D is detectability, if I can spell it correctly. And that is how likely it is to happen. And if you're going to be able to actually identify that it happened and fix it. So that is your risk probability number. Now, what you're going to do with each step in this failure modes and risk analysis, you're going to dissect every step of the radiotherapy process. So that means CTing the patient, the initial setup, contouring, doing planning, optimizing, setting up the patient, using Vision RT. Every step, you are going to look at potential issues that can happen in those steps, and then you are going to assign this O, S, and D value. Typically, they go from 1 to 10. And so you pretty much talk about all those steps, assign these values, and then at the end, you have a bunch of potential issues that could happen in your clinic. They all have RPN numbers, and the ones that have high RPN numbers are obviously the ones you want to focus on, because some of these or all of them are higher than other things. So obviously, contouring a colon is maybe, if that's a miscontour, isn't as big a deal as if you have a setup error of 2 cm. Obviously, that is a much bigger deal. And so that brings to light big issues and things that could go wrong in the clinic. So ultimately, now you can create new QA tasks and implement new workflows for those high RPN things to ensure better patient care. So now how would you create this? So first you would want to make a process map of everything that happens, and you need to assign these O, S, and D values that again range from 1 to 10. So 1 being that it's very little danger, or it's very detectable, or it's unlikely to happen, and 10 being the opposite, it's extremely dangerous. So next, who should be involved? So this is big. So you want to incorporate as many individuals as possible. So that means you want managers, you want physicists, you want dosimetrists, you want therapists, you want physicians, anyone who, I mean, heck, front office staff, anyone who has a, you know, of course there is a limit. Anyone who can participate, you want as many people as possible, because we as physicists see things different than therapists. So it's very important that everyone is involved and can bring their concerns up front and really contribute to this project. And so that's how you would create this. So you bring everyone together, you kind of divvy it up on who is going to look at this process. Typically, therapists are going to stay in the therapist realm, physicists stay in physicists. You're going to label all the things that could go wrong. You assign the OSD values, discuss those as a group, assign these, see which ones are the highest. And then as a group, you're going to come up with some things that would alleviate these issues and ensure that you are increasing your patient care. So that is TG100. That is failure modes and risk analysis. If you have any questions, please comment below. This is a great tool for medical physicists to be able to put and use in their clinic. It's a great extra project, something that really shows some knowledge and care for the clinic. So even in your clinic, if this hasn't been done, I encourage you, if you have the free time, to do that. So if you have any questions, please comment below. Thank you for watching, and happy studying.